Yeah.
So, hello and welcome. My name is Olafur Arnalds, and this is my good friend Viktor Ori Arnason, who has created with me a very special show here tonight for you. Viktor has made these rearrangements for this wonderful Sydney Chamber Orchestra, especially for tonight's show, so please give him a hand. Additionally, another good friend and a collaborator of mine has created this video installation also especially for the show, but he's not here tonight, so we don't have to give him a hand. No, I'm kidding, we should give him a hand. So, the show is also a little bit of a farewell show in a way for me. I've been touring around the world now for a few years playing this music and other music as well, and I want to stop. I'm tired. I want to go home. And no, not now, tomorrow. Don't worry. Don't worry, not just yet. So I thought before I go home and I start working on new music and thinking about the future, we should have this one evening to celebrate the old. So thank you for being with us. Now, before we continue, I would like to make a little experiment. Can you sing? You're more confident than you guys were. So, if you can actually sing, because a lot of people say this and then they can't, then I would like you to sing this one note with me. Don't worry, it's only one note. Maybe two if you're very good. And then I have these microphones here around the stage, and this little device here, I call him Mr. Jobs. And with this I can record your singing. And so we will just sing this one C here. This is called C. And we just sing it like if it's good, then I can use this recording in the next song. If it's not good, I have a backup recording on here, so it's okay. Don't worry, no pressure. So, should we do this? Just do it quite loud and for as long as you can without breathing, like one big ah. We have an opera singer up there. Amazing. Let's see how it sounds. It's pretty good, actually. There's almost everybody singing the same note. And that doesn't happen every time. Give yourselves a hand. Thank you so much for coming tonight. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. The next song we're going to play is a song called Poland, because I wrote it in this country called Poland. Usually when we're touring, actually everywhere else but Australia, it's possible to drive between cities, you know? You don't have to go on an airplane. Usually we have this big bus that we sleep in the bus while we drive through the night to the next city. And this is kind of a nice way of traveling. At least it's better than this airline with the red logo, you know, and shall not be named, but has lost our luggage more than I can count. it's nice, you know, you just go to sleep on the bus and you wake up and you're already in the next city. Except when you are in Poland, because the roads there are not really meant for sleeping. There were a lot of holes in the roads up there. And there was this one night, this actually a few years ago, we were driving somewhere, actually from Slovakia to Poland, and no one on the whole bus could sleep at all. We were just kind of jumping up and down in the bed. So at some point we all just gave up on sleeping and we started drinking instead. I like you. But we just found out that drinking on Polish roads is even worse than sleeping. It's really not a good idea. You just get very sick in your stomach. But anyway, we somehow managed and we woke up the next day. Somewhere in Poland, and everybody was feeling a little bit, you know, sad, as you do. And I wrote this song, so that's it. Maybe it tells us that not all sad songs have to come from heartbreak. There's many kinds of sadness.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's been a real pleasure to be here, finally, in the Sydney Opera House. It's something I've always wanted to check off my bucket list. You know. So, thank you so much for being here and coming. And special, extra special thanks to the Sydney Chamber Orchestra for playing so wonderfully with us. This song is called Near Light. Thank you for coming. you very much. Now work is finished and I don't think we're allowed to bring whiskey on the stage in the opera house, but as a wise man said, fuck the system or something. I'm sorry, Joy. thank you so much. We can do a couple of more songs for you, if you like. this next song is a song we haven't played, or I haven't played for quite a while, but I wanted to kind of leave it behind. It's a song from 2009, and actually I wrote it probably in 2007, came out in 2009, and I wanted to give it one final goodbye with this wonderful orchestra before I probably don't play it again. it's a nice song, don't get me wrong, but I think I've played it 500 times now. But never like this. It's quite a strange story. Sometimes I'm asked to write music for advertisements and stuff like that, and I usually don't like it, but and I usually just say no, but this one time they offered me like a lot of money. So I said yeah. You know, I do one bad job and I'll have a nice life, you know. But it was a really bad commercial. It was for actually, I actually saw a billboard from this company in Sydney, but I'm not gonna name it. But they make like bathtubs and sinks and stuff like that. Oh yeah. And it was this really bad commercial with a whale swimming in the river that goes through Paris. What's it called again? Yeah, and yeah, that one. And then suddenly, like, you're in the water and you're in a bathtub or something. It was, and there was like my music coming out from this stereo that was like installed into the bathtub. It was really bad, but you know, I decided to do it for other reasons. And I wrote this little melody and I sent it to them. I thought it was quite a nice melody, very fitting for bathtubs or something. But they didn't like it, and they fired me, and I never got any money. But I got this kind of nice song out of it, so I decided to just release it and see, you know. I made a little video to it, and like a week later, it had like 2 million views on YouTube, and it became my most popular song ever. and sometimes when I have some free time, I like to go on YouTube and I click on this video and I like to read all the comments. And all the comments are something like, you know, oh, he must have been so inspired by the Icelandic volcanoes and glaciers and the Icelandic nature. And I just sit there laughing because I wrote this song about bathtubs. Anyway, it's called Josef. Thank you so much. Thank you. Please give a great hand for Viktor Ari Arnason and the Sydney Chamber Orchestra. Did not see this. So, it feels strange now. I want to finish this concert with a little piano song that I have. It has an Icelandic title. It's called Lagfyrir Ömmu, and I wrote it for my grandmother. Lagfyrir Ömmu means song for grandma. And I wrote it for my grandmother after she passed away, because she was not only a dear friend of mine, but also the person who really got me into classical music. And she used to actually force feed me with Chopin when I just wanted to listen to some death metal. And but somehow she kind of got it down. And, and I think that's a big part of the reason for why I'm here today. It's thanks to her. So when she left us, I felt like I had to write her a little song. So I want to finish this with this on the piano. Thank you so much again for coming tonight. It's been absolutely wonderful. And I hope to see you again soon. Thank you.